Yeah, two conditions, and together they're sufficient for the increase.
That's what Alice does. Okay. Just hope, and hopefully that we feel until any of the next class group or other graduates will be meeting. First condition is satisfied, and keep our thoughts for real parallel, the only is.
Sorry, I don't understand what.
One of those, and then we check whether everything preserves health, whether these levels are valid. And actually, in this case, it's not true. When you exercise or check, then these guys do not preserve blood pressure.
How do you test if it preserves health?
I can see the people who.
They're getting. Ask them.
add those places where the levy factors are, but. Okay. What's on that?
Just to confirm, you got shared, in this case, there was every five square foot that was close to one that was shared, are what?
Say it.
Every five, so what's the brackets to kind of give you the type of parable, the simple roots?
Give me the type, and.
And every type is opposed to one, and sometimes you might have one more. Two, but.
That's right. The single and two does not preserve the levy factor. Right? Why doesn't it appear? Single and two that is not preserved by, anyway, by, well, I mean, they only include those orbit, and this does not preserve levy corresponding to.
No, I'm sorry. I was just thinking that the reason for what Mark said is what you said on the previous slide, that there was a single closed orbit.
Yeah. Right, so once you have a single PGP element, it's easy to, in Atlas, to define the labor subgroup. And Atlas, they define it as it is embedded in PGP. So for instance, if you let that. And then I usually look at the privilege representation in order to understand how this, like if levy subgroup is indeed embedded in PGP. And I think you haven't seen a lot of examples of parameters yet, but probably as you work with Atlas, see what I mean. Okay, so this is now the topic. This parabolic here because that's 301. And with the levy, this is the levy of E. And the Atlas tells me it's a disconnected the levy algebra is so far as the mark is not more than 301. It's just a geo plus two. It's disconnected.
Stable, like if it is. The perfect condenser, lowest P orbit, right?
Yeah. Lowest is the one of the minimum.
The ones who's see with this label zero, they're the lowest dimension.
One at the bottom of the diagram, so all the edges running out are of the dimensions.
One of the smallest dimensions.
They can have, I mean, the bottom can be many.
It can be more than one point at the bottom.
And they're all closed.
I think my students will take the screen series because they're all closed. Okay, so now that we have a parabolic and a limiting factor, functions. I'm going to talk about probably just real induction today. And so there's real induction standard is sort of a basic function which performs the induction standard module. It takes the standard module to a standard module, and essentially it just embeds KGB of L into KGB of G. That's the KGB element and adds some role shifts. Just to get any parameters of role shifts.
Role shifts is what would affect the lambda energy.
It only affects.
The embedding is what happens, I guess.
It only affects.
Sorry, what's the question?
Well, that role shift is real standard.
One subtle point here, which is everything's in the growth of the improvement. And when you induce from a real parabolic, you always get the same thing. If you fix the Levy factor, it doesn't matter what nilpotent radical you choose, you still get the same thing in the growth of the improvement.
After treating cells and closures.
Yeah, I guess my question should have been, why don't you need an L in there?
Because it knows L.
That's
the code.
Well, T is
the trivial L. Yeah.
Joe. Yeah. Looking at characters is certainly the fastest way.
That's the only way to know.
David?
Depending on what?
the fact that the induced guy doesn't depend on the choice of no radical for real parabolic direction. Perfect good proof to me.
On the mechanics of what happens to doing, there's still one thing that I'm not sure about. So T is a representation of levy, which is a group of steps in rank 2 and 3. So its components are numbered 0 and 1. So in a sense, it doesn't know it's attached to parabolic 0 and 2. I suppose what it does is assumes that they're using the same coordinate, so it can find the roots and then look up the roots among the roots of G and see, oh, my two simple roots are simple root 0 and 2 in G.
The hard part is relating the KGBs. I suppose you must do that early on somehow, put the KGB set for L.
That's the hard part. So you use these synthetic KGB elements to embed KGB for L into KGB for G. And that's the main step.
The lambda and nu part are just exactly the same on L and G.
Oh, so you can read the same an X that's an evolution and some...
And some fiber elements.
Some fiber elements, and you can actually reuse the same evolution and the same fiber element.
Well, probably the fiber element needs to be modified, I don't remember. But you can, just based on the original fiber element, you construct the appropriate one in G.
So basically, it's very much using the fact that the same coordinates are used for the two groups.
And if you think back, you'll remember that we worked this out a few years ago, and you were quite helpful. And this is when we introduced synthetic KGB.
It was that time recently. 4 years ago when you were helpful.
Jeff, can you assist?
Does it say battery low?
Sorry.
It
says something about that, yeah. It now doesn't say anything anymore.
I don't think batteries like they used to.
It may be that we're not turning it off at night or something.
No, we did turn it off at night.
Oh, good.
I mean, last night.
It representation on G. So this is P, the full standard, and this parameter also stands for the full standard on G.
But should the little B also be rho?
It's rho for the levy.
It's curious. So the first line is really doing induction on very large things, which is by the way, one dominant parameter. It's not entirely clear. It's supposed to dominant parameter correspond to that one. Is that the one that's the second
one? In here, it just adds things and it doesn't make it to dominant. In this one, there's a calculation involved. Some point, Atlas needs to have an there's some vector formula and then composition series.
Okay. So it's somewhat amazing that the Atlas is so small. There's a lot more going on than just calculating the same
thing. In here?
Yeah. Yes, the second one is doing the character formula and more things.
So Arnav is going to show us this 3 tensor 1 example, which will have maybe a larger.
This is going to have a well, depends on which three-dimensional you take, so.
I mean, you're using the same representation.
Yes, this is the standard representation.
No.
The other one is an irreducible representation. This is the trivial representation here that I'm using. Here I'm inducing the full standard representation that has the trivial as its Lycos quotient.
This is Atlas notation confusing us. The T is an Atlas parameter, and it's the parameter which Langlands attaches to the trivial representation of GL2 plus GL2. But Langlands also says, well, that trivial representation is a quotient of some principal series.
Yeah.
And in the first induction, what's being induced is that big principal series. And in the second one, it's the irreducible T that's being induced. It's the trivial representation. So in both cases, it's using T to tell you which thing you're talking about, but it means something different in the two places. The representation is different.
And the answer is the same too, but this one is the reducible also the Langlands quotient of G. So this one is the full finite dimensional
Thank you, Scott.
Then there's a mute button, a little light turns green. Now it's probably working.
Okay, are we working? Is it working?
So.
There we go. It's not green.
Yeah, now we can see it.
Okay, good. All right. Okay, so this is subtle and maybe we're going to be spending some time, maybe, I don't know, whether it's worth spending some time on it right now, but, okay, so I decided, well, let's sort of a three-dimensional representation of GL2, and I figured the highest weight would have to be 1 minus 1 in order to contain the trivial representation, the trivial k-type. And Atlas constructs, and then the trivial one on the second factor, and Atlas constructs the final parameter and gives me a lambda and a mu, again attached to the open order, to the actual ways that become touching. And then I'm checking, do I really have a three-dimensional representation? And yes, indeed. GL2 is disconnected, so there's another one with that highest weight, which I guess we can enter GL2 with a sign of the determinant, and that would just change the lambda, but not the nu, the lambda on the first two coordinates. And so I did that. I get another parameter. I just changed the entity, just changed the parameter by something of lambda. I get another three-dimensional representation with the same infinitesimal character, but they're not the same. So I'm checking here whether they are the same, and Atlas tells me they're not. And we know that there's, you know, the tension with the sign of the determinant, and then they're different. So I thought, well, why don't I try and use both of them and see what happens? Okay, so this is the first one. Actually, it is irreducible when induced up to GL4. The second one has four constituents. Okay, so this is the irreducible picture of induction. I am entering x equals 3 by hand, the way to... This is, yeah. If you do the real form and then the number as the first two entries in the parameter, you get that particular HUD element.
Is it not at all made by the same command as FD?
No, FD is just a shorthand. I think it takes the trivial representation and translates it to that character. And this one is, the second one is constructed by hand using the information from the trivial.
Do you have some magical procedure of changing the lambda? You did something with that.
Yes, I changed it by one. I changed it from, I don't know, even to odd, or on the first factor from even to odd or odd to even, whichever it is. Well, it's minus one over two, so it's a one, which is, yeah. I'm changing that. Or neither. And so if you enter the wrong thing. So for instance, KGP, the first KGP in this list, this is P1. KGP 0, that's the first key of the first parabolic in the list. Figuring out the levy factor is now GL2C. Yeah.
Then what is the infinitesimal fact of the induced representation?
The same as it's normalized induction.
So should I be looking for that induced representation as the trivial, the big block or something? I don't know how to find that representation as a representation of G. If I am trying to find out, look for that representation.
Just enter that, I don't know.
Some block.